हेलो एवरीबॉडी, दिस इज मसूद अंसारी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइकोलॉजी, APSM कॉलेज बरौनी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्सपेरिमेंटल मेथड एंड इट्स डिफरेंट टाइप्स। सो व्हाट इज एन एक्सपेरिमेंटल मेथड? एन एक्सपेरिमेंट इज एन इन्वेस्टिगेशन इन विच अ हाइपोथेसिस इज साइंटिफिकली टेस्टेड। इन एन एक्सपेरिमेंट एन इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल इज मैनिपुलेटेड and the dependent variable is measured while other extraneous variables are controlled. So this is good as it makes the data more valid and less biased. There are three types of experiments you need to know: lab experiment, field experiment and natural experiment. But in this segment we will discuss only one of the different experimental methods, that is lab experiment. Because if I will include all the three types of experimental method, video will be too lengthy. That is why I would like to prefer first one, that is lab experiment. Then after I will explain other experimental method in the next lectures. So first one is lab experiment. A lab experiment is an experiment conducted under a highly controlled condition where accurate measurements are possible. The researcher decides the place of experiment, time, participant, situation, and uses a standardized procedure. Participants are randomly allocated to each group. Each group means experimental group and control group. Now, first point is strength of the lab experiment, because every experiment has some strength and limitation as well. So first strength is easier to replicate. Why is it easier to replicate? Because lab experiment uses a standardized procedure, and who is interested to verify or reply or can conduct a similar study, they can replicate this lab experiment by following that standardized procedure. And second point is allow for precise control of extraneous and independent variables. As you know that lab experiment is highly controlled condition, and that is why it allows precise control of extraneous or independent variables like noise, temperature, sound you can say, and other factors also. Third point is cause and relationship to be established. Whenever we talk about the experimental method, our intention is to discuss about the cause and relationship factor. So these are the three strength of it. Now come to the limitation of the lab experiment. The artificiality of the setting may produce unnatural behavior. It is very clear and understood that whenever we artificially controlling any factor, there must be unnatural behavior. Okay. So which does not reflect real life. And because of this factor, external validity compromise. As a experimental or lab experiment is conducted in the highly controlled condition, so we try to control other extraneous variables, and we only measure those variables about which we are interested to study. But the rest of the variables, extraneous variables, are make constant. So second limitation of this method is experimental effects may impair the result and become confounding variable. So second point says that experimental effects may impair the result. So there may be some mental set, confirmation bias. So those factors can be impair the result of the lab experiment. So now come to the examples so that we can understand that what is the lab experiment and in which condition, how experimenter conduct this experiment. So first example is one study is conducted by Loftus and Palmer in 1974. His aim was to test their hypothesis that the language used in eyewitness testimony can alter memory. So thus, they aim to show that leading question could distort eyewitness testimony accounts and so have a confabulating effect. As the account would become distorted by cues provided in the question. It means there is a role of the language in the memory of eyewitness testimony. In this experiment, Loftus and Palmer is trying to verify is there probability that language may influence that eyewitness testimony memory. So they conducted one experiment in which they have selected 45 participants, and this was a laboratory experiment with 5 conditions, only one of which was experienced by each participant, in which experimenters provided some video clips to the participant of the accident, and which was ranging from 5 to 30 seconds, were presented in a random order to each group. Each group means control and experimental group. After watching the film, participants were asked to describe what had happened as if they were eyewitness. They were then asked specific questions, including the question about how fast were the car going when they smashed, collide, bump, hit, contacted each other. It means these are the 5 conditions which were used to the different groups. In this experiment, researchers have emphasized only 2 terms, smashed and hit. Thus, the independent variable was the wording of the question, and the dependent variable was the speed reported by the participant. Now, come to the finding, what they found. Estimated speed was affected by the verb used. The verb lied, information about the speed, which systematically affected the participant memory of the accident. Participants who were asked the smashed question thought the cars were going faster than those who were asked the hit question. This is the trick to modify or to influence the memory in this experiment especially. The participant in the smashed condition reported the highest speed estimate 65 km per hour, followed by collide 63 km per hour, bump 61 km per hour, hit 54 km per hour, and contacted 51 km per hour. I mean to say is that as per the use of different conditions like smashed, collide, hit, contacted, or bump, it influenced the answer of the participant. Consequently, researchers found that the result shows that the verb conveyed an impression of the speed the car was traveling, and this altered the participant perception. In other words, eyewitness testimony might be biased by the way questions are asked after a crime committed. Loftus and Palmer offered 2 possible explanations for this result. First explanation was response bias factor, in which they explain the misleading information provided may have simply influenced the answer a person gave, but did not actually lead to a false memory or event. For example, the different speed estimates occur because the critical words smash or hit. Influences or biases are person's response. And second explanation was the memory representation is altered. The critical word changes a person's perception of the accident. Some critical words would lead some to have a perception of the accident being more serious. This perception is then stored in a person's memory of the event. If the second explanation is true, we would expect participants to remember other details that are not true. So, in this experiment, Loftus and Palmer trying to understand that what is the role of language on the memory. By showing different video clips of the road accident, and then after they asked the participant leading questions, or you can say loaded questions, that what did happen when cars were smashed to each other. When we talk about hit, then we can say like this, hit. But when we talk about smashed, this is smashed. So, impression of the language or words, we can say, has a very significant role on the participant answers. So, in this experiment, they found that, yes, language has its significant role impact on the answer of the participant. And then Loftus and Palmer tested this in their second experiment. They themselves tried to verify this result and conducted another experiment. In that experiment, 150 students were shown a 1 minute film which featured a car driving through the countryside followed by 4 seconds of a multiple traffic accident. Afterward, the students were questioned about the film. The independent variable was the type of question asked. It was manipulated by asking 50 students how fast were the car going when they hit each other. There were 150 students, and out of 150 students, 50 students were asked that how fast were the car going when they hit each other. Another 50 students were asked how fast were the car going when they smashed each other. And the remaining 50 participants were not asked any question. And this is the control group. First two groups are experimental group and third one is control group. 1 week later, the dependent variable was measured. Without seeing the film, again they answered 10 questions, one of which a critical one randomly placed in the list, which was not before, it was included. Did you see any broken glass? They have to answer in yes or no, dichotomous answer. So while there was no broken glass on the original film, but now see what is the influence of loaded question. Finding shows that participants who were asked how fast the car were going when they smashed were more likely to report seeing broken glass. That means those participants who were asked that how fast was the speed when cars were smashed? And then asked that there were any broken glass? That group of the participants says yes. Why? Because their response, their answer was influenced by the language, that particular word that is smashed. Suppose if you are asked the question, that same question, like how fast were the car when they were smashed? If both cars are smashed like this, anyone can imagine that glasses must be there, broken glasses must be there. While if I ask what was the speed when cars were hit each other, then this will be the situation. In this case, there may or may not be pieces of broken glass. So language that is used in this experiment shows that there are the influence of the language, impact of the language on the participants' answer or responses. Consequently, this research suggests that memory is easily distorted by questioning technique, and information acquired after the event can merge with original memory, causing inaccurate recall or reconstructive memory. Now come to the answer of the participant. Responses were like this. Who were asked about the smashed word or loaded question by smashed word? So first experimental groups replied that out of 50, 16 participants replied that yes, we have seen, I have seen the broken glass. While in the second experimental group, in which the question was asked by using by hit word, there were 7 participants out of 50 who replied this yes, I have seen broken glasses. And in the control group, who was not asked by any word, using any word, either hit or smashed, they reply, six participants replied out of 50 that yes, I have seen broken glass. There may be probability that yes, if car are getting stuck in an accident, there is probability that glass may be broken. The result from experiment 2, that is smashed and hit word uses the experiment, suggests that this effect is not just due to the response bias, because leading question actually altered the memory a participant had for the event. The addition of false details to a memory of an event is referred to as confabulation. This has important implication for the questions used in police interview of eyewitness. So this is the all about lab experiment in under the experimental method, in which researchers have conducted 2 experiments, and in one experiment they only shows the video clip to the participant, while they asked about the only speed, they did not ask about the broken glasses, they only asked about the speed, and there were also various answers on the 5 scale, we can say, which was used as smashed, collide, bumped, hit, contacted. So there were also variation in the answer because of word which were used in the question. And in the second experiment, where participants were asked about the broken glass, again using the same five conditions. So it shows that yes, word or language has its significant impact on the answers of the participant. So this experiment was conducted in the laboratory and highly controlled condition where other extraneous variables were not present except that independent variable about which researchers were interested to study. So in the next video, we will discuss about the field experiment, and if you have any question related to lab experiment, you can put your question in the interaction session. So thank you for your patience.